been hunting.
There, a signal. And the source is at the top of the mountain. I'd better look into it.
May there be songs in your name.
This grove, anyone can commune with the machine spirits as the shamans do.
The talks are just waiting. A good sign, I guess. You're not going to be the one to stop.
We are your chumping shard purses!
Did Vilgun send you? I guess shards can buy a conscience.
Never mind that. Nora girl, you have to stop the others. Up ahead, we snuck up here. Uncovered some kind of ancient device, plain as an anvil. That's what affects the machines.
The other bungheads voted to take it to Pitchcliff for auction. But it's taken a beating already. Like it dropped from the sky.
We tried to stop them digging it out. Without that thing up here, those Banuk will be massacred.
I'll stop them. You two get out of here. It sounds like you've already done enough damage.
Well, that's a fair appraisal.
You bunch of chuff dolls. The slack was on your end.
What have you done?
Who are you? You're not one of those Banuk.
Too late. Let me look at it.
Hold on. This was our delve. We did the work. You want to put your axe in? What's this thing worth to you?
I don't know about this. This was your idea. You started it, you can finish.
All right. Could be this thing's just scrap. But even scrap has a price. So I'll ask again, what's it worth to you?
It's worth more to me than you are. You still want to negotiate?
Forget it. All ye's ever given me is black toes.
They've made a mess of this. Catastrophic malfunction. This is from long ago. And it's been sending a signal all this time. Fading out. I have to get back to the camp before the machines tear it apart. No, they've already started attacking.
The hunt is back.
Oh.
machines are angry. Keep your distance. Hunters, defend the camp. Do what you must.
Yes. Roar and rend at me. I don't fear it. And rend at me. I don't fear it. Now you'll hear my song, machine. A sharp song. Now you'll hear my song, machine. A sharp song.
Problem.
Full already.
I wish you were at on.
What a loss.
Nora, did you know this change would come upon us?
Not
Exactly. Although I know there is a lot changing in our world. This time it was outsiders. Those Oseram thought.
The Oseram do not think. They will never understand the balance between us. Between man and machine. Now the blue light has gone. And we are left with many songs. But more for mourning than gratitude.
So what now? Will you go back to your homeland?
When we teach the young to walk on shifting ice, we say, the secret is taking one step, then the next. Perhaps one day, we will understand the machine's mysteries.
I hope so. Good luck, Teacook.
Deserves. I'm supposed to sit here, but any of the outlines of the machine will get you. Go for a drink. No?
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no outlander. Are you looking for... Wait, I know your face. You came back. How did we fare?
Expensively.
That's what I was afraid of.
The tame machines, it's hard to explain, but there was a kind of signal that calmed them. Your men got greedy, so it's gone now.
Gambling's a shoddy job, girl. I should have been a weapons dealer. That's steady work. Here, take it. The half I'd owed those hammer-handed chunks.
Half? I finished the job. And what was it you said? Enough to buy a more becoming garb?
What do you want? Karja silks? Ah, hoisted on my own purse strings.
Can I interest you in a reasonable share of a lucrative opportunity?
Spending so long away from the hunt makes my
Ouch. This must be the pass Tor was talking about. It's a new predator. Can see the heat coming off it.
Okay.
Damn, no more of these. I can get out of this. pain's drawing back. Good hit. Stay out of their way for now. Forget about traveling light. Useful. That's a welcome, I guess.
You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
This is Song's Edge, biggest settlement in the cut.
These are dangerous lands, Outlander. Deadly, even.
This isn't Ban-Ur, not quite.
You've come on a dark day, that's for sure.
You're a long way from the sacred land, Nora.
You'll leave soon, I'll wager. Your body or spirit or both.
Smoke rising from the mountain. And the village, too. What's it for?
How are we to trust the chief? So many died.
Must be something big going on.
Songs.
Most of the village is moving towards that smoke.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora. Burgrind. Purveyor of necessities.
Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead. But not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye. A nasty business. All their best warriors. Lost.
So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. Falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us. And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Our blood is in your teeth, Oratok!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
The daemon that frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best. And what do they want to do? Go back up there. Fools. A little advice, for free.
Aloy.
Aloy. I've been up here for two long winters, and I still can't make sense of the Banuk. Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Aurea, spouting on about spirits and demons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Warwick up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines. When Aurea vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her. But no. Here's Big Aratak, gearing them up to do it all over again.
What is it about the Banuk you can't make sense of?
Well, everything's a test to them. A hardship to endure. A challenge to survive.
Seems like they don't have much of a choice in a place like this.
Yeah. A land cold enough to crack teeth. Filled with wild animals. You'd think they'd accept a little reasonably priced aid. Well, believe me, I've tried to convince them. But a Banuk with nothing left to prove might just lie down and die.
And Aurea is the one who spoke about this daemon?
That's right. Told Aratak and the others that it lives up on Thunder's Drum. And they believed her.
But you don't.
Look, I don't know what Aurea found up there. A shaman's not going to talk to an outlander. The machines in the cut are getting more vicious, that's a fact. It could be because of the daemon. Or it could be because they all got indigestion, for all I know. But Aurea's not around to explain. She took off, and no one knows why.
Is Aratak a renowned warrior around here?
He's a Warwick chieftain. His voice carries a lot of respect. Not that you hear much of it. Man talks about as much as a dead fish. But when he and Aurea came to town with their Warwick, it drew more Banuk to this little burg than I'd ever seen. Know what else I saw, Aloy? My own little trade route, stretching all the way back to the claim. Then, he goes and leads them off to their death at the claws of angry machines. So much for my best customers.
You said you've lived out here for two winters?
Aye. Back home, some fur traders told me about this steel-forsaken heap of tents. Good location. Ripe for change. We were barely scraping by until this place started filling up for Aurea. A great prophet is coming, they said. Oh, I heard prophet. Honest mistake. Not that the Banuk are stingy, they just prefer to keep trade among themselves. We could get through to enough of them. We could really put this place on the map. Or at least on a map.
I want to know more about this daemon.
Mm-mm. It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then, you need to find Aurea. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks. But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow. Strange new structures. Some say a new machine, like no one's seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Bergrund.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if Aratak can tell me more about Aurea.
Thunderstorm. To be gawked at by
maybe worth a shot.
I do not want to hear this talk from you again. Doubt is heavier than a week's snow.
Forgive me, my chieftain. We will be ready for the next attempt.
But this will not be an attempt. It must be done. Do you understand?
My chieftain.
Good. Outlander, I suppose you wish to speak?
You're set on going back to the mountain?
I put my word to it.
Even with the risks being so great?
The risk of what? Death? It would be a worse fate to bow our heads to the challenge and say, too much.
Did your Warwick come from this place?
No, he rallied most of our hunters from across Banyur to face the threat of the demon. But I was born here and stayed to fight the Karja when others retreated into the mountains. A few of my old warriors remained with me, those who survived.
There are other Warwicks in Song's Edge too?
Yes. The village has its own life for all Banuk who need trade or shelter. After the war ended, it sprang up from what was once a campsite, quick as the bloom between frosts. Perhaps it will last till the Karja seek war again.
Well, I guess that's it then.
Good. I prefer deeds to words.
Right.
Yeah, you.